Hearty welcome back to our newest episode of Ask the Founder, dear Simon. Thanks that you take your time for our questions. And today we have very interesting in my eyes, because the future multiverse is changing the world as we know it. AI is being used here to take our everyday business life to a really new level. Companies, organizations, and people are being brought closer together than is currently possible and normal. Where previously a spatial separation could only be overcome in two dimensions, this is now possible in three dimensions, multidimensional, at least virtually. One of the benefits of this is that business can scale much faster because trust can be built up much more quickly between previous strangers. This is incredibly valuable from an economic perspective. But how will this be accepted on an emotional level that will reach the point of mass adaption? So perhaps you can tell us something about that. And I think it's a really interesting question.
Thank you so much for this question. I think it's a very important one. First of all, everyone is already talking about AI now. So AI has been, let's say, the toothpaste that has been put out of the box just recently, when you look at it, basically. So it just has publicly or unofficially, let's say, mass adopted since a few years. Now everyone is using it, but everyone was using it very fast. Now is even very soon already taking it for granted. So they already have the feeling that this has been around all the time, and they use, many are using it on a daily basis now. So in our case, specifically with our way of how we have implemented not only AI, but our entire platform, which basically where AI is one technology, let's say one key technology of several. You mentioned, let's say, the aspect of 3D, which is a very key one. Interaction cross-border, basically from everywhere around the world, can now happen within seconds. You can basically, with a link that you click, you can enter a hyper-realistic 3D VR environment to, for example, a specific meeting where just before, basically, we were having a Zoom call, or you were basically looking at a YouTube video, or you're interacting in a 2D environment, basically, using the internet. But 3D in VR in a hyper-realistic way, and let's say that in a seamless and easy way, if you can, let's say, navigate to a specific point or, let's say, a specific project you're interested in. So imagine you have a search engine, you can basically ask the search engine with AI, for example, you're looking for a specific project, or you're interested, for example, as a buyer or investor, or for...
You want to buy a car, for example, and you're looking for a car dealer.
Or for example, you always wanted to travel to Bhutan, but never have been there because not everyone has been to Bhutan, for example. Then you can basically search this search engine on our platform in the future multiverse, and you can enter Bhutan. And then it really allows you then to click on, it will show you basically the environment, Bhutan. You can click on it, and then you can basically travel to Bhutan in a hyper-realistic way with your own avatar, and then go to a country, to a nation, touristic sites, or into an environment you've never been to, and you maybe only have seen 2D videos from, or as you said, to a car dealer or to a real estate object. Then you can navigate in this environment in the way you want. Not basically in the way
that's
that it was
incredible.
Shown to you in,
that's
a,
really
in, a, 2D, in a 2D video, but in a really easy and simple way will change, especially on our platform, because we have an exhibition where we bring together so many really groundbreaking, mind-blowing solutions and really exciting projects and products. And people can, you know, they can look for a certain car brand, for example, they're interested in BMW. Or whatever luxury brand, Rolls-Royce, or whatsoever. Local, innovative, really innovative car that has been built in Africa, for example. Then you can directly travel to the garage where this innovative car is being built, and you can directly go there, and you can then interactive, open the door, you can sit inside with your avatar, you can open the front of the car, basically look at every aspect of it like you're actually touching it in VR. In a super interactive way.
And you see, and even if we show this to the people, they do not believe that. So that's why I'm asking, okay, when do you think it will be a mass adoption that people believe what happens? So AI, okay, more and more people use it. And perhaps in the Eastern atmosphere, it's more normal than in the Western. Yeah. But these points are so incredible and unbelievable.
Yeah.
Wow.
The thing is, the more people that will, in a seamless, super easy way, access our platform, and then, for example, Muslims in a digital way accessing Mecca, people as SpaceX enthusiasts, basically, from, for example, Hong Kong, can now access the SpaceX launch site in Canaveral, Florida, or the Texas Star Base, for example, where the starships are basically taking off to Mars. And they can buy a ticket, basically, for a day ticket for an on-site experience or even on-board experience.
On-board experience? Wow.
Just teasered a few things. Now people will see.
You're kidding.
So we have projects that we have already digitized or in the middle of finalizing right now in a way where really fans, you know, space fans, for example, they can have an experience. I've personally never been to the US when basically a big rocket has taken off, and I'm a big fan of it as well. So, you know, people will be able to not just look at it on a TV screen or at a YouTube video, but they can enter the environment where it happens and then interact to the people who are also there within a second. You can say, look, you can invite me to a certain event basically that you're at. And you can say, look who's there. You know, you can, and who's digitally there? One person from Alaska, the other one from China, from Hong Kong, from South Korea, from Japan, from America, one from Italy, one from Latin America, from Panama, and one from Kenya, and one from South Africa, for example. And they can all meet in one environment via click, basically, mm-hmm. and then have a meeting like they're actually sitting next to each other, either in a boardroom for a business, for a company.
So people who are thousands of kilometers away from each other, they can meet. So if you see, for example, older people that nobody visits them, or families that are divided by thousands of kilometers, they can meet within the future multiverse and shake hands and hug themselves. So this is really incredible. If people believe this, if they see this, that it happens, that it really happens.
The moment they experience it, and when they will see, whoa, this is something I've never experienced in this way before. And the more people do that, it will have a mass adoption in a speed, in a way that has never been there before. Now, we are converging AI with hyper-realistic 3D VR experience, which is easily accessible, seamlessly accessible, where you can own your own data decentralized. Mm-hmm. For individuals, their own avatar, to have a hyper-realistic avatar for all the people in the world is a completely new thing. And to have, let's say, their own digital identity, but then owning their own and managing their own data decentralized and then streaming to their platform, having the ability to always disconnect and knowing, okay, this platform actually, I don't have a risk that someone is basically taking my data and just using it for something else. Same for a company. Very important. You know, right now on Google, you can go to Google Images and you can just download any logo that you want, although you don't own it, and do whatever with it. So this is not going to be possible on our platform. Or the other thing, you know, we had the brother of the president of a country when we had a private setting basically with them, and they said, okay, if we proceed with this now, first question, where's the data going to be? Mm-hmm. First question for sure. A nation. Now,
very, very important for governments.
Game changer. Yeah. Total game changer in the way of how we've built our platform. Now, when the more individuals, companies, asset owners, governments see this, and they see all the different functionalities that they can use it for. It's built in a universal way. It can be used for any different, let's say, use case that is in alignment with our codex. As you mentioned in the other episode, we have also rejected companies which are not in alignment with our core vision and values. But the more who will get in touch with this, test it, see it, feel it, and see, wow, so many different ways of how this can be used. People will love it, because in a fast way, in our public launch, we are directly launching in many different countries, the whole world, basically. Yeah. And because we have project all continents in many different countries and engaging many different communities, populations, companies of different kinds, governments of different kinds.
So watch out our other episodes and the other tutorials and videos we have on our YouTube channel. So watch them out to see all these projects.
If people think that the internet in 2D was already exciting, wait for it. If you have your own digital individual entity, corporate entity, or even government, and you can join basically this 3D VR hyper-realistic environment, and you can offer your products, offer your knowledge, your coaching courses, your nation for tourism, your exhibition, your event of whatever kind, and you can basically offer this for people, creating value basically for people to experience, for people to interact with. You know, you can meet a friend that you have and on the other side of the world. You can meet them for a get-together, and then basically within an instant, you can join an event, you can do so many different things together. And also, of course, if you can use the internet in the next level of efficiency, efficient, seamless, and also meaningful way, is an incredible thing. And AI is integrated into it, which everyone uses. Blockchain is integrated, which technology that many people around the world are using on a daily basis. They have the freedom of using their digital assets to do trade, offer them for trade, but also they don't have to use it. We have so many different big freedom of how this platform can be used, how this technology can be used in, though, a secured, protected way. Where you also said, you know, in regards to a trusted environment, the most amazing thing is everyone who's using the platform has to do a KYC, so has to basically legitimate themselves. So also we're creating, let's say, a layer of protection for individuals, for companies, for governments who are using the platform. On the one side, from end users who are willing to buy something or are interacting with someone else in any way, but also for entities or anyone who's offering something on the platform. So we're basically creating a protected environment where people know, okay, the people who I interact with, the entities that I buy from, or basically the buyer who's buying my product. It's a trusted community. There's no comparable platform online, in fact.
No, not at all. It seems to me that there are some different points. So hearing you, okay, streaming something live and going to a starbase or things like that, being part of a rocket launch. So this sounds like fun. And I think people would join the Future Multiverse then. You mentioned as well the word meaningful. So it's not for fun, this platform. We are a business platform and everyone can use it for business and scale his business because of AI. Yes. And so there are many different points why Future Multiverse will be the biggest platform for this as well, and why I believe now that mass adoption is possible very soon, because we are just in front of the public launch, and you said everyone will have access to the Future Multiverse from the very beginning, and some people will use it for fun. The most of the people will use it for business purposes, and we are here for everyone. So, and if the people see how easy it works, what you mentioned as well, so there won't be any barrier to say, okay, I can't be part of it because of technical problems, because I'm not a technical nerd. I use the technique if necessary, but I'm not that one who wants to go into the deep. And this is something why I say Future Multiverse is right for me. I can use it in a very easy way. So thank you very much, dear Simon. This is very interesting. And I think we will have many, many millions of people joining Future Multiverse from the very beginning. Thank you very much. And everyone else, keep in touch with Future Multiverse. Keep in touch with our episode Ask the Founder, and see as well all the other videos that we provide you with. Follow us and see the projects that are already online. Bye-bye and see you next time.
Thank you so much.